All right, everyone, some more DC fandom content and more DC video game content. So this is Gotham Knights. We have the official Court of Owls story trailer. And after this, there's also like a little behind the scenes featurette that they have, which is another trailer just looking like it's going to show off the process of making the game, how far along they are. I'm not certain, but we will know when we watch it. But first, I'm going to watch and react to the official story trailer. As I'm certain many of you know by now, I love the Court of Owls storyline. I think they just are an amazing, super cool organization within Gotham that is one of Batman's greatest threats and foes. So very excited to see them bring it into here and just kind of see more gameplay, what they've cleaned up from the last time we saw Gotham Knights. A bit of it had me worried and not, I don't know, on the fence about the game itself. So let's see this trailer, see what they've added new, and yeah, for both of them, let's watch them get into them.
Batman.
So he is dead.
Jim Gordon.
Dead.
They thought they had a handle on this city. They never did.
Oh, there's Red Hood.
You don't stand a chance. Because they're always watching, always listening, pulling everybody's strings. Mine, yours.
Here's the Talon.
But no one talks about them. Not a whispered word is said.
The Court of Owls is a myth.
They're listening.
Ooh. Okay. I love how atmospheric this trailer is. Definitely gonna put the detective skills to the test.
Rabbit hole, you need to know there's no coming back from it.
Okay. I like that trailer. 2022, still no quite or firm release dates, but 2022. And I want to see the talent, but I like how atmospheric they made this trailer, just to how powerful they showed the Court of Owls to be. Because they're just, like I said, absolute menaces, and I love them. I love the organization. I think it's just such a cool storyline, and kind of sucks that we don't get to see Batman, or maybe we do, but we don't get to see Batman being the one to tackle this on. But I'm sorry, the kiddos can do all right. And then let's get a closer look at the Talon. Who was it who was following with him there? With Red Hood. Oh, a member of the courts. Okay. So one of Gotham's most rich and powerful elites. Makes the dust. Alright. There is one in like four battles. Yeah, there he is. That's going to be a tough boss fight for sure. All right. Yeah, no, I did like that trailer. It looks pretty good. I love, too, how Penguin's basically just telling him, like, I'm terrified of them. You guys should be, too. If the most powerful criminals can't take him down, what do you think you guys can do? All right. Let's see. Official behind-the-scenes featurette. lots of
one of the joys of writing comics is the hope that someone will take that story and make it something their own. And I think the folks at Warner Brothers have done a tremendous job translating and evolving the Court of Owls into the game.
The fans, they cosplay these characters, they're hungry for more.
And so here you are getting to play out that conflict in a game itself.
I'm gonna have to see more.
I remember taking this walk around New York City, my old neighborhood. Nothing I knew was there anymore. All of the people I had known had moved away. All of the stores were gone. The feeling was so unsettling, and I wanted to craft a story that would make Bruce Wayne feel the way I felt.
The first time I read that story, I was just blown away because they were creating this really rich secret history of Gotham City, very plausible, believable.
Such a good story.
That was in direct opposition to Batman.
I think probably inspiration for the Court of Owls originates from nature, just by the real fact that the owl is a natural predator to the bat.
What an owl does a lot of the time is it hunts you and it stalks you without you seeing it. And the fun of the way that the court goes after Bruce is to watch him from afar for years.
Because it's been something that's been in Gotham for so long and been so powerful and right beneath Batman's nose, I think that's the root of the success there.
So yeah, they understand the court, which is
really
good to
hear. One of the biggest challenges with bringing the Court of Owls from comic books to video games is really the interactive nature of what video games are.
How do you take that history, how do you take this cool imagery and bring it to life in a game that's very satisfying?
We could look at the source material, we could talk to the creators, and we could ask their opinions about that. We could say, which of these elements do you think we can translate?
When I went out there to see what they were doing with the game, I was blown away. I mean, it took what we had done with Court of Owls, but it just elevated it beyond a lot of the
orders that we had. It looks like they truly understand the course, and that makes me very excited.
We have expanded, we have added to it.
There are different varieties of talons in Gotham Knights. And as the players begin to understand through gameplay the unique strengths and vulnerabilities of the talon, it will affect how they equip themselves and how they unlock new abilities. So like any good RPG, we're presenting you with a problem and then we're presenting you with a range of potential solutions, and players will have an opportunity to kind of maximize that according to their own style.
The entire team has worked so hard on this and put so much love and dedication into this, and I really hope it comes through and it gives them a really enjoyable experience.
I can't wait for us to share more information about
really
this
like
game.
Sure,
but watch out
cool.
for those deadly talons, because they are sharp. Be careful.
Okay, so definitely story-wise, I'm very excited for Gotham Knights because I can truly tell that they know and care about the Court of Owls storyline. It looks like a very, very well-crafted story in terms of, just like I said, the Court of Owls, the talent, all of this, and just the huge secret role that they played in Gotham for years and years. And yeah, there's a lot that you can do with this storyline, and I'm excited for it. Like I said, I still need to see more gameplay before I make my mind up about this one. It looked clunky. There's a lot of things that I didn't like from it, so we'll have to see more as they show it off before this releases sometime next year. I'm assuming they're probably going to go for a summer release date, so they have a lot of time to show us and build upon what they've created here. But I am very excited for the story. So please, in the comments down below, let me know what you thought about just two of these trailers for Gotham Knights and how excited you are, what you're most excited to see, how hyped are you to see the Court of Owls make their way into the Arkham universe. And yeah, if you like this video, definitely give it a thumbs up, and you can check out all my other trailer reactions and everything I'm doing DC fandom wise through my playlist down below, and I'll also link some up top here. Turn the subscribe, turn the little ring around if you want to know when I upload new videos. And just awesome, guys. Super excited for this one to come out and play it. And yeah, it seems like it's going to be a really fun, great, well-crafted story.